welcome back to my channel. So this is my most up-to-date, most beautifulest, most defined twist and curl ever. So if you're interested, keep watching. All right, so we're gonna just jump right into it. I am starting on freshly washed hair, and I'm gonna just take one section, and I've already applied my twist and curl cream and my coconut oil, and I've detangled, and now I am twisting. So my twist and curl cream of choice is Bella Curl's Curl Defining Cream, and the coconut oil that I'm using is also by Bella Curl's, their coconut oil. So I've twisted until about an inch and a half to 2 inches down, and then I'm going to apply a perm rod. You will see me using white and purple perm rods, and basically that's just because I like my twists to have a little bit of, I don't know, differentiation. I guess I don't like uniform twists. So anyway, moving on to the next section, I'm just going to take this medium-sized section of hair, apply the curl defining cream, and then I'm going to detangle, detangle, detangle. That is the key to my twist outs. And the reason I say that is because I have 4ABCZ hair, and it loves to hang out with each other. And that can create a lot of frizz. So I have to detangle, detangle, detangle in order to make sure that I minimize the frizz when I'm separating. So anyway, I have detangled, I've twisted, and applied a perm rod, and I'm just going to continue to do that all over my head. So on to the next section, I'm going to apply some curl defining cream and detangle. Like I said, that is the key to my twist outs, detangling, and also I would say doing my twist out on wet hair as opposed to dry hair. My hair takes forever to dry, so it is a pain in the butt sometimes, but my twist outs turn out so much better when I do them on wet hair. So I'm applying the coconut oil, detangling some more, and then I'm going to slow it down for you and just show you really quickly. It's just a basic twist, and I'm going to leave, like I said, about 2 inches of hair untwisted at the bottom, and then I'm going to apply a perm rod. And that is pretty much my technique. So the key to my twist outs, like I said, just to reiterate, doing them on wet hair as opposed to dry. Not saying that I can't do a dry twist out, but if I just want that really bomb definition and a twist out that's gonna really last me for a good long while, then I'll definitely do it on wet hair as opposed to dry. So wet hair, detangle, detangle, and then when I think I'm good, detangle a little bit more, and just take my time separating. I think those are the three keys, I would say. So I'm applying one last perm rod, and then I'm going to move on to the takedown. So I apply some coconut oil to my hands, and I'm just going to take down, take all of the perm rods out, and then the coconut oil just helps me to minimize frizz when I'm separating my hair. Down the twist, and another thing that helps me minimize frizz is I try to kind of feel for where the hair seems like it already wants to separate. So I try not to create separation, I try to find separation and then just work with it, if that makes sense. So I mean, sometimes I have to kind of forcefully separate, but usually if I run my fingers up and down the section, I can kind of feel where my hair is kind of starting to separate on its own, and then I just go with it. And that is pretty much it, you guys. I'm not gonna stay here and talk y'all ear off, because I know y'all trying to pay attention so y'all can get this bomb twist out. But I want you guys to come back next Wednesday and every Wednesday after that, because it is my goal to get you guys a video every Wednesday for the remainder of the year and hopefully on into 2018 as well. So I believe I'm going to be dropping a bro hop video next Wednesday, so make sure you come back.